It is 0 degrees Celsius outside. That's the freezing point, and it is, of course, overcast. So I found a podcast that sounded really interesting because they do ghost hunting and stuff like that, and tell ghost stories and whatnot. And they were at the Lizzie Borden house, which is supposedly incredibly haunted. And they got a lot of EVPs and stuff like this. I heard this on another podcast that I listened to, and they were talking about it. And they of course say go over to their podcast and listen to the pod about the with the EVPs and all that, so you can hear that. And so I did. I went over there, and after the fourth ad in a row at the start of the before the podcast even started, I'm like, nope, and I just deleted them from my feed. No, I'm not going to sit there through 4, 5, 6 whatever the hell ads just before you start. And sure enough, they're going to have mid reels as well, so you know, it's just, it's going to be 50% ad content by the looks of it. So they're gone. I use Amazon Music for a reason, because most of the podcasts I listen to are on there ad free and whatnot. So there's only one that isn't, and it literally has one ad at the beginning and one in the middle. And that's it, and I can tolerate that. But you're going to have 4 freaking ads at least at the beginning of your podcast. I'm not listening to you. The other thing is, I looked them up, and they're supposedly a really successful podcast. And they've got a large Patreon audience. So you're getting a ton of money through Patreon, and you're doing a ton of ads, and probably doing sponsored content as well, because the people that have a million ads always do sponsored content as well, because you know, the ads aren't enough revenue. We have to have sponsored content talked about in the podcast as well, so you know. That's always the way with these people. And I just love how they come on there. You guys make it possible for us to podcast. Not really. Anybody can podcast. You just sit there and talk to your phone and, you know, whatnot. And you can podcast. Anybody can do this. Literally anybody. It's not hard. It's not rocket science, and it doesn't cost you a shit pile of money, you know what I mean? Sure, if you want better quality, you're going to have to buy a microphone and all that, but that's an investment of about $60, and you're set. So, you know, I don't know, man, I don't know. They make it seem like it's very expensive to produce podcasts or something, you know. It's like people saying, it costs me so much money to present vlogs, and they're not doing anything more than most of the people I see. So, and they're not sucking back on a whole bunch of ads and revenue and stuff like that. They're not monetized at all, you know. And they can put out just as good a vlog as you and whatnot, you know. I don't get it. I just don't. I don't ever want the monetized thing. I know there's ads stuck on all our videos now. We have no choice in that anymore. We can't say no anymore. We used to be able to say no to ads, but you can't anymore. They're going to stick them on there whether you like it or not. So, you know, yeah. Anyways, I did a few puzzles. I've been working my way through the AI ones that I've the mini AI ones that I posted for download. I'm on the ones that Henrik and Colleen did, my friends Henrik and Colleen. AI art, I'm working through those. I've got I must admit I cranked down the I made them easier. I cranked down the number of pieces on them from 80 to 50, so they're easier, but I'm zipping through them like crazy, of course, because of that. But you know, and on what's it, Deep Dream Generator, which is the one the AIs I use for free because you know I can. And I had earned 100 points because when you inspire people to use your parameters, your prompts, that is, they click the try button and it comes up with your prompt and their thing, and they can edit it or go with what you had or whatever. After you get 50 of those, you get 100 points for free. Bonus points. So I was up to 58, and I'm like, hey, I got a free thing, free 100 points. So I made more puzzles, just because I don't have enough puzzles, you know. I've got what is it, four folders, four or five folders of art that I've collected from a several sources as well. That I want to make into puzzles eventually, but you know, not right now because I'm just having fun doing them. Anywho, I have made actually a couple of not safe for work ones, puzzles, folders of puzzles. One that has Cupids, and one that's I forget what the other how the other one was. It doesn't matter. But I've got four more to go for the not safe for work ones. Four or five. I think it's actually five. There's four art ones and a furry one. A single character called Biddy that I encountered. Anyways, yeah. Yippers, yippers. I like puzzles. I like making them too. So, you know. I've got a ton of the AI ones left, of course, and whatnot. Anyways, the ones I made with my bonus points, I made 33 puzzles. I made them bigger than usual. Usually I have 80 or 100 pieces. I made these 250 pieces, or 254 or whatever the hell it was. 250 something anyways, pieces. They're gonna be bigger than normal. Of course I'm doing two folders at once now, Colleen's and Henrik's. Did the mandible challenge for the day as well. I've done three tries or whatever. I think three tries. Other than that, there's not much going on today. I don't seriously don't feel like watching TV right now. I'm really enjoying the cartoon Captain Fall. It's really funny. It's very politically incorrect. It's very not much not politically correct at all, but it's funny to me. I like it. Anyways. Other than that, I'm probably just gonna play some more puzzles. And whatnot, and make some vegetable soup later, and whatnot. I did give in and got the pizza yesterday, which I shouldn't have done, but I did. So yeah, I fired down a pizza. I got enough for coffee outing, and maybe a bag of chips after the coffee outing. So yeah, that's it, that's all. You have a fabulous time, keep smiling. Every penny counts, by the way. Count your pennies.